Today, we're going to generate a presentation in Canva using its AI features, and then we're going to export it and make it accessible. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump right in. The first thing that I'm going to do is go to canva.com, and let's select the Presentations tab, and then let's create a blank presentation. From here, I'm going to select the Magic Design button by Canva, and then we're going to select Try It Out. There is a small window that opens and it says, use five or more words to describe your presentation topic. And let's do one about accessibility. So let's try accessibility, section 508, design principles, and then hit enter. And from here, we get to choose a specific style. I'm going to select this one that has block text. I can just tell that some of these fail color contrast requirements, so I'm going to select the one that passes and then select create my presentation. And then right away, we already have a presentation built. Let's take a look at some of the contents. Accessibility in section 508 design principles. Slide 2. Section 508 is a law requiring federal agencies to create websites and digital content that are accessible to people with disabilities. That is true. That is what Section 508 is. Interesting, the image that they chose. This appears to be a volcano or tectonic plates moving. Let's go on to slide 3. Principles of Section 508 design. Provide text alternatives for non-text content. That's pretty good. Ensure that all functionality is operable through a keyboard interface. Pretty good. Use colors and contrasts effectively. That's decent. Those are some principles of 508 design. It's not everything, but it is something. Importance of accessibility in design. Use high contrast colors, add alternate text images, use descriptive link text, provide keyboard navigation, and use headings and lists. Not too bad. Let's check out slide 5. Techniques to ensure accessibility. Again, this isn't incorrect, but it's missing a lot of information. And obviously, it says this technology is new and improving. Benefits of designing for accessibility. We have design for accessibility benefits everyone, and then a summary slide. So not too shabby. Let's go ahead and download this presentation. I'm going to select the share button and then select download. And we have PDF standard or PDF for printing. We could also do a PowerPoint file. Let's go ahead and do PDF standard, and then I'm going to select download. All right, let's go ahead and open this file up, and we can begin to make it accessible. So the first thing I want to do is actually review the accessibility of this document. Let's open up the tags panel, and oh my gosh, look at all these div tags in here. We're going to need to fix this a little bit, but it surprisingly has the content tagged, so I'm not angry at it. All right, let's go down to this figure tag and this P tag, and I'm going to drag them both up above these 1 million part sections, and let's see if we can find the rest of this. I'm simply just taking the figure tags and the P tags. I'm holding my control key as I go through the tags panel, and what I'm trying to do is just get all of this content out of all of these nested div tags. All right, we got all of that content. Let's do a control X, and then let's paste it under our top level tag. And if I select this part tag with my highlight content button selected in the tags panel, I can tell that these are just blank. So I'm going to delete the part tag and delete the part tag. And now we just need to clean up our document a little bit. The first thing I notice is this figure is out of order with a lot of the headings. So accessibility in section 508 design, this should be a heading level 1. To change that, I'm going to press F2 on my keyboard and replace the tag from a P tag to an H1. I can then right click the figure tag and select properties, and it actually put in alternate text for this image. I'm impressed. I can go ahead and leave that in there, select close. Let's move on to slide 2, and we have a heading level 2, which I'm going to press F2 on my keyboard and change it to a heading level 2. We have this figure. I want the text above the figure, so I'm going to move that tag by control Xing and Control V. And then let's review the alt text on this. 3D illustration of a scientific ground cross section to explain subduction and plate tectonics. So that is an accurate alternate text, but it's not really related to our content. So I'm actually going to artifact this image. To do that, I'm going to select the image tag, right click, and select change tag to artifact, and select OK, and then delete out the figure tag. And let's keep going here. We want our text before our image, and I'm going to change this text to a heading level 2. We have our 3P tags in here, that's fine. We have a figure tag, which is also going to be artifacted. And then we have some text that we need to move around. This will also be an H2 tag, and the figure tag is irrelevant, so we'll change it to an artifact. And then we have some text in here. It's technically in a list, but it's going to be a little challenging to make that into a list item. But we can go ahead and do it. So the easiest way to turn this into a list, there's 5 list items. I'm going to right click and select new tag and create a blank parent L tag, followed by 5 blank LI tags. And I'm doing this manually. And let's expand. All right, let's open up the reading order tool. And I'm going to select the 1 and just mark it as text paragraph. And then we're going to say use high contrast, make that text paragraph. All I'm doing right now is trying to separate out the numbers from the text. And because this is on multiple lines, it's a little tricky. We could also do this other method. Well, let's finish up this first list item. So this P tag, actually, first I'm going to move all the LI elements into the list element. And then every LI needs a label and an L body. So I'm going to change this tag to a label. And then I'm going to condense down these other P tags and move this tag inside the label, because I'm trying to build an appropriate list. An appropriate list item contains an LI parent tag, a label, and then the L body. So that's what I'm trying to build here. And then because I tagged some of this, I have to clean it up. So there's another method we can use where I could simply create the LBLs and put them inside of their LI tags. So let's do that first. So I'm right-clicking new tag, creating a label, and then placing it to its home. All I'm doing right now is creating the placeholder. Next, I want to create an L body tag for each one of these list items. So every list item has a label and an L body. And what we can do on the second one here is with my label tag selected, I can highlight the text number 2, go to the tags panel, and say create tag from selection, and it will automatically place that content. Next, I can grab the text for L body, select the options panel, and create tag from selection. And then we'll just do the same thing for 3. Tag from selection, select the L body, select the text that we want, create tag from selection, take the LBL for number 4, create tag from selection, L body, take the text, tag from selection, number 5, same thing. So there's multiple ways that we can create an appropriate list item. And there we go. Now we have appropriate list. I'm going to artifact this blank tag. All right. And it appears both of these figures can be artifacted. I'm going to select both of them, right click and change tag to artifact and select OK. We can then delete out the figure tag. Let's go back up to the top. We have our H2 list. We have another H2 followed by 3 paragraphs. And then we have our final H2. And now we have a tagged document. From here, we can drop it into various accessibility checkers. But let's first run the Adobe accessibility checker. I'm going to select the accessibility button and then select accessibility check and then select start checking. And it passes this criteria. Let's go ahead and open up the pack tool and test our file. And it looks like we're missing quite a few things. So let's first expand our issues. All right, we have a bunch of path objects not tagged. So to fix this, I'm going to open up the content panel and expand all of the pages, and I'm going to select all of these paths, right click and select create artifact. And that is how you fix that error. But I need to expand it one of these pages, right? And I'm holding my control key and I'm going to select all of those paths one by one on every page. Whoops. Right click, create artifact, select okay. All right, let's see what our other errors were. So path object not tagged was the first one. Let's see, logical structure. Our figures are missing bounding boxes. Let's see if that's fixed with our new version of this document. So I'm gonna save the file. Let's drag this in again. All right, something was fixed. Let's see the results in detail. Structure elements, figures, bounding boxes. All right, so this has no bounding box. All right, so that's the figure on page one. Let's go back to the tags panel, find the figure, right click, select properties, select edit attribute objects, and I'm going to select new item, select the dictionary that it created, select new item, and we're gonna say bbox, and then change this to array, and select okay, and select okay, close, save. Let's test the file again. Actually, what's the structure? Oh, possible inappropriate use of a figure structure tag. That means it's missing another attribute. So let's right click the tag again, select properties. I'm going to select edit tag. And in the dictionary, we're missing the placement attribute for block. So in the dictionary area, I'm gonna select new item. For my key, I'm gonna select placement. And then for value, I'm going to type block and then select okay, then select okay again and select close. And there's one other thing that I need to do, which is add the PDF UA identifier. To do that, I'm going to open up my print production tool, and then we're going to select pre-flight, and let's select the single wrench fix and type in UA. And right here we have the option set PDF UA and select fix. Let's save the file and close this out. Let's open up the pack tool once again, drag and test our file, and voila, we have a document that passes PDF UA requirements, and it passes WCAG 2.1. So you just learned how to create an AI-based presentation in Canva, export it to a PDF, and then make it accessible. As always, I can be your personal accessibility expert. And to find out more ways that I can help you, check out the links in the description of this video. Thank you for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.